Feminist Creativus presents a word for every generation that knows no fashion.
Greetings. I hope and trust I still find you well, my friends. We are continuing from where we left off on Friday. And for this morning, we want to consider the Minority Report as it is articulated in Numbers chapter 14. And we begin reading at verse 5 in the Holman Bible. It reads as follows. Then Moses and Aaron fell down with their faces to the ground in front of the whole assembly of the Israelite community. Joshua, son of Nun, and Caleb, son of Jephunneh, who were among those who had scouted out the land, tore their clothes and said to the entire Israelite community, "The land we passed through and explored is an extremely good land. If the Lord is pleased with us, he will bring us into this land, a land flowing with milk and honey, and give it to us. Only don't rebel against the Lord, and don't be afraid of the people of the land, for we will devour them. Their protection has been removed from them, and the Lord is with us. Don't be afraid of them." May the good Lord bless the reading of His word as we spend a moment in prayer. Let us pray, my friends. Kind and gracious Father in the heavens above, thank you, dear Lord, for the privilege of hearing you speaking to us this morning. Train our ears to listen unto you. Tune our minds to follow after thee. Dear Lord, many are the voices that are pulling us in all directions. But above all, may we not overlook the Minority Reports. This has been our prayer of faith. In Jesus' name we pray and we ask, Amen. My dear friends, as usual, just allow me to raise 5 points as we take off for this morning. Point number one, notice that as the book of Numbers sets off this morning, it says, Moses and Aaron fell down with their faces to the ground in front of the whole assembly of the Israelite community. May I submit unto you that many an organization, many a nation is in need of leaders that are prayerful. Leaders who will know that when the things are getting out of shape and the wheels are coming off, it is time to kneel down and call upon the Lord. Leaders who will not be ashamed to seek the guidance of God, to seek the intervention of God as we take off this morning. Are you in a leadership position? Consider seeking the guidance of God. Consider seeking His intervention. At point number two, notice this. The Bible says, amongst those who had gone, there was Joshua the son of Nun and Caleb the son of Jephunneh. Why do I want to single these out? Not particularly because they gave the Minority Report, but because they were a minority in the literal sense. 2 out of 12 gave this report. As I was trying to work this out, it translates to about 16.6%. or 17% to round it off. If 17% of the people gave a dissenting opinion, would we go with the majority or will consider the views of the minority? May I give you a word of caution, advice for free. Not in every situation, not in every scenario is the majority always right. At times, the minority may be right. Take time to weigh issues. Take time to consider the flip side of the coin and hear what other dissenting views have to say. Most probably, your answer, most probably your life hangs on that minority report. And what did these gentlemen submit in their minority report? Point number three, notice what they say. They say, what we want to be sure of is that having done a whole analysis, considering the 10 aspects that we've said, these are specialist areas that everyone should look at. What we need to appreciate is that over and above our research, there is an element that supersedes. There is an element that transcends everything. And this element is to be found in verse number 8, where the Bible says, if the Lord is pleased with us, We may do extensive researches. We may call upon the best of the specialists in the field. But unless and until the Lord is pleased with us, guarantee of success is not ours. Until and unless the Lord is pleased with us, we may not taste victory. This is made clear in the Minority Report. Ladies and gentlemen, as we take off into our workspaces, we can conquer. We can emerge as victors. We can become the best only and if only the Lord is pleased with us. What shall it take for us to find ourselves on the Lord's side and He be pleased with us? The Minority Report does not leave this out. Notice at number 4, it says, do not rebel. Don't rebel against the Lord. Many a time, we want the Lord to be pleased with us, but we are walking in the opposite direction of where He sends us to go. God says, this is the road, walk ye in it. But most of us are rebelling, and we expect to succeed at the end of the day. The Minority Report is clear. Caleb and Joshua say, ladies and gentlemen, make sure the Lord is pleased with you. And for Him to be pleased with you, you shall not rebel. What is to rebel? It is to go up against the will of the Lord. What is to rebel? It is to be in direct confrontation with a thus saith the Lord. What is to rebel? It is to go against a set standard. And this is true even of our workplaces. There are codes that are set. There are policies, there are governance instruments that are set. When we go against these, we are rebelling. This will not please our earthly masters, neither will it please our heavenly master. At point number 5, as we come to an end, they say, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Many a time it is fear that conquers us before the battle begins. Many of us are defeated before we even go into the spaces where we are supposed to conquer, where we are supposed to excel, where we're supposed to fly on the wings of an eagle. We fail because of fear. If we can conquer fear, we have every reason to go out in the strength of the Lord. Many a time, why do we fear? We fear because we think our enemies are greater than us, and we think we are vulnerable. Now, to respond to these unasked questions, they say, as far as your enemies are concerned, do not be afraid of them for the following reasons. Number 1, their protection has been removed from them. You have a multi-layered protection from the Lord, for no weapon formed against you is going to prosper. Secondly, notice this, the Lord is with us. As you go out, child of God, not only are you protected, but the Lord is with us, and He that is with us is greater than they that be in the world against us. Trust the Lord. He will lead you through. Trust in His word. It is bankable. May you depend upon Him to be a refuge and a shelter in the time of storm. God will see you through, my dear friends. Trust the Minority Reports. It is not how the majority tell us to go. It is not by numbers, but it is by who is on our side. With God on our side, we have nothing to fear. Until we meet again on Friday, may the good Lord prosper you. May He keep you. May His blessings and His peace be countenanced upon your life. In Jesus' name, amen.